In this example, I'm going to look at an autothermal reactor, which means that the heat reaction from the exothermic reaction is used to preheat the reactor feed. And to the figure is an annular region around a packed bed reactor. And so the feed enters this annular region. As it moves through, heat of reaction is exchanged with the feed gas. So the gas at this point is being heated from the catalytic reaction. And then this gas enters the reactor much hotter than the initial feed temperature. And of course, the rate of reaction is faster at the higher temperature. What we want to do is determine the conditions in the reactor and the exit temperature given our feed temperatures. We're given a temperature T1, and then we want to determine our final reactor temperature. The problem is that to solve the differential equations as initial value problems, we need the temperature that's right here, and this temperature we're going to call T0. In order to make this initial value problem and calculate and solve the mass and energy balances in the reactor. So what we're going to do is guess T0 and then calculate T final and T1. If we guess the correct value, we will then end up with the T1 value that we already knew. If we guess the incorrect value, then we're going to iterate until we get back our initial starting value. So we want to go through what the equations are and what this procedure is. There's a couple things we have to be careful about. And we're going to look at the case for an A goes to B reaction that's first order and gas phase. And the procedure then is described here. What I'm going to do is first start with the material balance for the reactor, material balance on A. I'm going to write this as the change in the molar flow rate of A, moles per time, respect to the cumulative volume, or the cross-section times the distance down the reactor. This is equal to the rate of reaction per volume, which is this. So the differential equation that we're going to substitute into numerical integration package for the material balance is this. Now I'm going to write down mass balances. And so important, what we have to be careful about is Z. So at this point, that corresponds to Z equals 0. And this is our Z final. What we want to do is integrate in this direction. So we'll likewise write down now the energy balance. This is the energy balance for the packed bed. Right, in terms of the density of the material, the volumetric flow rate, so that's the mass flow rate, and this is a mass heat capacity. And the change in temperature with distance down the reactor is equal to heat of reaction per mole times the number of moles reacting. We have the cross-sectional area just like we did in the mass balance. This minus sign is here because overall, for an exothermic reaction, this term should be positive. And then we have the term for heat transfer, which is in this form, and describe elsewhere why that's the form. Radius of the tube containing the catalyst, the cross-sectional area, and an overall heat transfer coefficient. This is the temperature in the annular region, and this is in the packed bed. So we're referring to, in this region, T sub A, and inside the packed bed, we'll use the symbol T. And so then we need, as our final balance, a balance on the annular region. This is of similar form, except we don't have any reaction in that region. So we have a density, a volumetric flow rate, and same mass heat capacity, change in temperature A, but I'm going to call this ZA. So this is where we have to be careful. ZA means moving in this direction. So ZA equals 0 here, and then it increases as we move to the left because that's the direction of flow. Then the term on the right side is the heat transfer term. That's the only term that we have for heat exchange. There's no reaction. And it has the opposite sign because we're removing heat from the reactor part and preheating our feed. We have to be careful with signs. What we're going to end up doing is saying, as you can see from our drawing, dz is minus dza. So therefore, we could take this equation, remove the a, and put a minus sign here. So we can integrate with respect to just one variable, and indeed we can, of course, multiply both sides by minus sign and make this plus, so that we have now three equations that we're going to solve simultaneously as initial value problems. So at z equals zero, we know the flow rate going into the reactor. And at z equals zero, what we don't know is the temperature going into the reactor. So at z equals zero, temperature is T0. And indeed, z equals zero, the temperature here is also T0. So T0, remember, is this temperature at z equals zero. They have to match since it's the same stream. And that's where we make our guess. So we guess T0 and then we solve. And the energy balance in the annular region at z equals z final temperature is T1. This is what we know. So we know T1. We're going to do this integration. We're guessing this, and we're going to integrate. If we don't get the correct value for T1, we guess a different T0. So what I'm going to show you is a polymath program that goes through this calculation. So here's the polymath program and then the results. So let's look first at the polymath program. We're given T1 is 316, the feed to the overall system. And then we adjusted T0. So this is the final result where I've run the program multiple times, adjusting T0 until at 545 Kelvin, I get as my final temperature for the annular region to 316 Kelvin that I've already given. And so what I have is a mass balance, the energy balance, the annular region energy balance, the heat transfer term. Length is 7.5, this is in meters, and heat of reaction, the various terms. I've accounted for the fact that the volumetric flow rate for the gas changes with temperature using an ideal gas law where volumetric flow rate is related to molar flow rate, which is a constant. The gas constant times temperature divided by pressure. Given the overall heat transfer coefficient, the radius. Here are the units that's used in this polymath calculation, and here are the results. So let's look at the flow rate as a function of distance through the packed bed. Of course, the flow rate of A decreases as reaction takes place, and it looks like we have about 70% conversion. This is temperature, again, as a function of distance. Our inlet temperature, coming to 316, this is 545 Kelvin. So the temperature increase is because of the temperature difference between the packed bed and the annular region. And then this is the temperature in the packed bed because the reaction, it increases until we get to a point where this temperature difference becomes large and the rate of reaction slows down because the concentration of reactant is decreased. That now the temperature starts decreasing in the packed bed region. The point to keep in mind is the signs for the energy balance in the annular region. And using this iteration, which is actually very quick because the solution of the differential equation is very quick, we can determine using what's referred to as a shooting problem, making a guess and solving the differential equations.